Banerjee, you want to raise an important issue.
Sir, mic.
Mic aayega,
Thank you, sir. Sir, I am making this 0-hour submission in this August house to our...
I have already told him, they have taken note. Once the Home Minister comes, he will respond to this. Yes, Home Minister was not well,
sir,
yesterday.
Sir, please note the time.
Please.
Sir, I am making this 0-hour submission in the August House to urge upon the Union Government to clear the name Bangla in place of West Bengal as proposed, as passed by the West Bengal State Assembly. Sir, West Bengal came into existence due to the partition of Bengal during our independence. Bengal was at its peak of nationalist movement at the dawn of the 19th century and eventually emerged as a formidable threat to the British Raj. To curb this nationalist movement, the Britishers decided to divide Bengal in 1905, a move vehemently opposed by various leaders of the time, including Rabindranath Tagore himself. The British government passed the orders of partition in August 1905, which came into effect on October 16 in the same year. Tagore deftly used the concept of brotherhood, togetherness, and the threat of protection as a medium to protest against the partition policy. Following Tagore's clarion call, thousands of Hindus and Muslims in Kolkata, Dhaka, and Shillet came out in the streets to tie Rakhi threads as a symbol of unity, celebrating Raksha Bandhan. Tagore's firebrand pen created immortal songs of anti-partition. Amar Sonar Bangla, Ami Tomay Bhalobashi, Chirodin Tomar Akash, Tomar Batash, Amar Prane Bajay Bashi, Amar Sonar Bangla, Ami Tomay Bhalobashi.
Sir,
both songs of Tagore became a war cry for the proponents of the annulment of partition. Due to the political protest, these two parts of Bengal were reunited. West Bengal and East Bengal came into existence when the Ratcliffe line was drawn from Debiganj of Kochbihar in the north to Sundarban in the south. Now the people calling their
mother in the same tongue, wearing
the same dress.
Brother, please, sir, conclude.
Sir,
conclude.
I have time, sir. I'm just making the point. The people calling their mother in the same tongue, wearing the same dress, having the same food were bifurcated. Now, sir, in 1971, Bangladesh was formed. Today, sir, the geographically no part of then undivided Bengal is known as East Bengal. East Bengal name remains only in history and through a century-old formidable Calcutta football giant called the East Bengal Club. Sir, so it is necessary now to change the name of West Bengal to Bangla. In all languages, the West Bengal State Assembly has passed the resolution in September 2017 in this regard. Sir, through you, I will urge upon the Union Government to clear the name of Bangla and honor the sentiments of the common people of West Bengal.
Thank you.
Jai Bangla, Sonar Bangla, Bishwa Bangla.
Thank you. Dola Senji, Dola Senji.
Associate, sir.
Yes.
Associate, sir.
Associate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Please. See, Mr. Dola Sen, government is taking note. Leader of the house himself
sir,
is here.
For
please, time, come here.
Sir, thanks for giving me the opportunity to deliver my 0-hour submission today.
Bhattacharya.
Subject of 0-hour of my submission today is vacancy for the position of chairperson of National Green Tribunal. Sir, you know that Justice Satantar Kumar ji retired as the chairperson of the National Green Tribunal on December 19, 2017. Several important disputes are currently sub judice before the tribunal. Chief among these disputes are, one, a plea against alleged illegal mining of minerals in Saharanpur and the Jamuna riverbed. Two, a matter on the issue of crop burning. Three, a plea raising the issue of worsening air quality in Delhi. Four, a matter about the alleged encroachment in the Agar Velandar wetlands. Sir, all of these matters have wide implications and require urgent hearing. These issues are only indicative of the very disputes that the National Green Tribunal hears and deliberates on. Sir, National Green Tribunal Act gives the responsibility to the central government to appoint the chairperson in consultation with the Chief Justice. Sir, so far the government has only named as acting chairperson, but we think that in the absence of a full-fledged chairperson, the tribunal would not be well equipped to function effectively. This is not the first instance of delay in naming the chairperson of a tribunal. For instance, Justice Sirpurkar, who was the chairperson of the Competition Appellate Tribunal, had retired on August 21, 2014. His replacement, Justice Singhvi, was named on October 2 after a six-week gap. Sir, our tribunal system can function effectively only if the government is proactive in naming replacements.
Right, ma.
The government was fully aware that this vacancy would arise on December 19. They were also aware of the several important matters currently sub judice before the National Green Tribunal. Justice Kumar's replacement should have been named in advance. Sir, we urge the government to announce the new chairperson of the National Green Tribunal as early as possible for the sake of our nation and for sake of all our citizens.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, Tiruchi Siva. Associate these two members. Gupta and then Nadim ji and also Rajiv ji.
Sir, thank you, Chairman, sir. Sir, the fireworks industry in Sivagasi, Tamil Nadu has closed all its 840 factories due to the impossible situation caused by uncertainties. Sir, a fear of all India ban on fireworks has frightened the firework factory owners, thereby losing their licenses. They stand to lose their licenses, sir, and 8 lakh people are standing in the streets and the whole city is deserted. Because of this, the firework buyers have not made their investments, and so there is no purchase order for the past 1 month. Sir, the fireworks industry works for throughout the year, but the sales is for only 1 month before the Deepavali. And so, sir, since the investments by the buyers form the basic capital of the industry, and some 8 lakh people are depending upon that industry, sir, and no other country in the world has imposed a ban on fireworks. Sir, every function is being, festival is celebrated with fireworks. In the US, it is the Independence Day. In the UK, it is the Guy Fawkes Day. And in the China, it is the Chinese New Year's Day. And why in India it is so, sir? And so, sir, it's not only the fires. Pollution is not because of fireworks only. There are so other causes of emission like the road dust, emission, vehicular emission, stubble burning, and thermal plants and all, for which there is no control, sir. Sir, after Deepavali, this Deepavali was celebrated in Delhi without fireworks. But Delhi was not devoid of pollution. It was literally a gas chamber after the Deepavali without the fireworks celebration, sir. So, sir, it cannot be considered that one day will cause the whole pollution, but it costs the lives of so many people and the industry, and it earns a lot of foreign exchange to our country, sir, through the fireworks industry. So, sir, this has to be taken up very, very seriously, and we have to keep in mind, sir, and this is the only product which there is a mechanism already with the Government of India to control the emissions. The Firework Research and Development Center has been created by the Government of India to undertake research and come out with eco-friendly fireworks, whereas the other emissions have no control, sir. So the only request to the government is an exemption from Rule 3B of the Environment Protection Rule 1986 will only be a permanent solution. So, sir, the government should take it very seriously, considering the lives of so many people and the economy of the country. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Shiva. The minister want to respond.
No, I'll convey. I just want to say that the issue raised by Honorable Tiruchi Shiva is very, very important for that region. And with your permission, I'd like to convey that. I'll certainly convey that to the concerned minister.
Right. Thank you. In America and other countries, it is all electronic fireworks, not the this one. But anyhow, leader of the house is here. Minister said that they will convey it. I too is concerned because there is a divided opinion on that. Some people are very strongly sentimental. Then Sri P.L. Punia.
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद सभापति जी. भारतीय रेल से संबंधित मैं विषय को उठाना चाहता हूँ. भारत का रेल नेटवर्क विश्व में चीन के बाद दूसरा सबसे बड़ा रेल नेटवर्क है, जिससे देश का अमीर हो या गरीब हो, लगभग 2 करोड़ 30 लाख यात्री प्रतिदिन यात्रा करते हैं. लेकिन यात्रा समय पर और सुरक्षित पूरी होगी, इस पर गंभीर प्रश्न चिन्ह लगते हैं. एक तरफ तो देश में बुलेट ट्रेन की बात की जा रही है, वहीं दूसरी ओर रेलवे सुपरफास्ट चार्ज लेकर भी ट्रेनों को समय पर नहीं पहुंचा पा रही है। सरकार ने गत 3 वर्षों में 200 मेल और एक्सप्रेस ट्रेनों को सुपरफास्ट ट्रेनों में बदलकर स्लीपर में 30 रुपया प्रति स्लीपर और एसी में 45 रुपये से 75 रुपया प्रति यात्री शुल्क बढ़ा दिया गया सुपरफास्ट चार्जेज के रूप में। ट्रेनों के देरी से चलने पर भी यात्रियों को सुपरफास्ट का बढ़ा हुआ किराया ही देना होता है। हालात यह है कि कई ट्रेनों को सुपरफास्ट बनाकर सुपरफास्ट की स्पीड में नहीं चली है आज तक। सरकार ने रेलवे को जनता से लूट करने का माध्यम बनाया है। सुपरफास्ट चार्ज लगाकर रेलवे एक ट्रेन से सालाना 1.5 करोड़ की कमाई कर रही है। भारत के नियंत्रक सीएजी ने भी इस पर कड़ी आपत्ति जताई है। अतः आपके माध्यम से मेरा निवेदन है कि सुपरफास्ट ट्रेनों के देरी से पहुंचने पर यात्रियों से लिया गया अतिरिक्त चार्ज वापस करने की व्यवस्था की जाए या इस तरह का चार्ज लिया ही ना जाए। लगातार लेट चल रही ट्रेनों को वापस डीग्रेड करके मेल या एक्सप्रेस में बदला जाए। समय पर सुरक्षित यात्रा के लिए डॉक्टर अनिल काकोडकर कमेटी के सिफारिशों को भी लागू किया जाए।
धन्यवाद। आप बहुत अनुभवी है। लूट ऐसा शब्द प्रयोग नहीं करना चाहिए। रेलवे एक पब्लिक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है। ठीक है, मैं आपका भावना समझ सकता हूँ, मगर वो ऐसा शब्द नहीं होना चाहिए। इफ यू वांट टू रेस्पॉन्ड। यस
अध्यक्ष जी, माननीय सांसद ने बहुत अच्छी बात कही है। सब चिंतित रहते हैं ट्रेन लेट होने पे, लेकिन वर्षों से जो सुविधाएं बननी चाहिए थी रेल में, वो 50 साल से, 40 साल से, 30 साल से सुविधाओं के अभाव में रेल्स के ऊपर जो ट्रैफिक है, जितना फ्रेट चलता है, पैसेंजर्स चलते हैं, उतना पर्याप्त इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर ना होने के कारण, और सभी सांसद आते हैं, सभी जनता की उम्मीद होती है कि और ज़्यादा ट्रेन चलें, और ज़्यादा स्टॉपेजेस हों, उसके कारण स्वाभाविक है कि सुविधाएं बढ़ाने की सरकार कोशिश करती रहती है। आजकल फॉग का हम सब देखते हैं, रोज सुबह फॉग कितनी रहती है, हम सब देखते हैं। सेफ्टी इम्पोर्टेंट है, इसके लिए ट्रेन में थोड़ा विलंब होना इन दिनों में हम इसलिए टॉलरेंस करते हैं।
व्हाट इज द रिलीफ यू आर गिविंग?
कि हम सेफ्टी के ऊपर ज्यादा प्राथमिकता देते हैं। सेफ्टी इन्वॉल्व्स ट्रैक रिन्यूअल। ट्रैक रिन्यूअल इन्वॉल्व्स दैट ट्रेन्स आर गोइंग टू गेट अफेक्टेड। अगर ये समय पे इतने सालों में किया गया होता तो शायद ये समस्या आज नहीं है।
ठीक है, धन्यवाद। श्री विवेक गुप्ता, संक्षिप्त में प्लीज, और बाकी लोगों को भी मौका मिले।
सर, थैंक यू फॉर गिविंग मी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी।
आई डोंट थिंक एनीबॉडी विल आस्क फॉर मिनिस्टर्स रेस्पॉन्स आफ्टरवर्ड्स, बिकॉज दे विल बी लूजिंग देयर टाइम।
सर,
टाइम।
सर, थैंक यू फॉर गिविंग मी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी। सर, इंस्पायर्ड बाय माय लीडर श्री ममता बनर्जी, आई एम हियर टुडे टू टॉक अबाउट द 50 लाख कुर्मीज इन वेस्ट बंगाल। सर, mysteriously in 1913 they were part of the scheduled tribes and scheduled caste list, but in 1931 mysteriously they were removed from that list, and since then they have been ignored. Even in 1950 when the master list was prepared, they were again ignored. So recently the West Bengal government has formed the West Bengal Kurmi Development and Cultural Board in 2017. Sir, my leader has tried in her own way to give them recognition and benefits. Sir, she is trying to revive the Kurmeli language, which is dying, and the Jhumar dance form, which is again being listed as a heritage dance form and supposed to be protected by the National Planning Commission and the Niti Aayog as well. Sir, but these people are mostly living around the forest areas, and somehow they have been described as tribals, but even they are not getting any benefits under the tribal acts also, or on other benefits available to tribals. Sir, just 2 minutes, 1 minute. Sir, the All India Kurmi Kshatriya Mahasabha, which was formed in 1910, has been fighting to include the Kurmis in the central list of backward classes. Sir, through you, I would request to the government to give them their due recognition, include them as a scheduled caste, as my leader has demanded, and give them their due benefits so that they can also get their recognizable dues. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Sir.
You tribe. Kurmi, mere khayal se already backward class hai. Now, scheduled tribe ka mang. Theek hai. We'll go on record. Dr. KVP Ramachandra Rao. Doctor.
Vipulavaji.
Dr. Ramachandra Rao. No, he has a neck problem.
Sorry, sir. Extremely sorry for the house. Sir, subject implementation of AP Reorganization Act in this in its true letter and spirit. Synopsis of the matter. Sir, the then government, with the consent and demand made by the then opposition BJP, has made several provisions for all-round development of successor state of Andhra Pradesh in February 20th, 2014. But even after the expiry of nearly 4 years, the provisions in the Act are still to be implemented. The ruling party in Andhra Pradesh, which is in alliance with BJP and running the government...
Issue.
Sir, implementation of the AP Reorganization Act in its true spirit and letter and spirit, sir.
No,
that is the demand, so sir.
You want to see that the letter and spirit of the Act is implemented. That's your main demand, no?
Yes, sir. What are all the clauses, all Reorganization Act clauses to be implemented in time, sir, without burdening the state in any way?
Thank you.
That is it.
Thank you. Only thing is, the point, you take party's name, then they will say something, you will say something, the matter is gone. That's my worry. Otherwise, the point which you have raised, okay, it will go on record and government will look into that.
Government of India to immediately implement the provisions of AP Reorganization Act 2014 in its truth, letter and spirit, sir.
Thank you, Ranjana Raji. Professor M.V. Rajiv Gowda.
I wish to bring to the notice of this House a proposal being considered by the U.S. Department of Homeland Security under President Donald Trump. The plan is to not extend H-1B visas for those waiting for green cards, which would grant them permanent residency. So currently, such workers are allowed extension of their H-1B visas, usually indefinitely, until the green card processing is completed. So if this proposal is accepted, H-1B visas holders would have to exit the U.S. till the processing is completed. This has the potential to adversely impact the lives of lakhs of Indians who are at the risk of deportation and will also affect their families and their companies. So, more than 50% of the 85,000 H-1B visas currently issued every year go to Indians. Based on the backlog, there are more than 2 lakh Indians with H-1B visas who will be affected by this. So, they are huge contributors to the wealth creation in the United States, so it's bad for the U.S. also to do this kind of disruptive move. Still, it's being considered. I urge the government to engage with the U.S. administration as well as with Indian and American companies to address this issue. Otherwise, to make plans to assist all these people who are facing the risk of having to come back home in a disruptive manner.
Thank you. Rajiv Shukla to associate.
Yes, sir.
Vivek Tanka and then...
चेयरमैन सर ने भी कहा है कि बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट इशू है. हजारों जो भर्ती हुआ है वहां पे, उन सब का जो है करियर खतरे में आ गया है और उन सबको जो वापस भारत आना पड़ेगा, फिर ग्रीन कार्ड का इंतजार करना पड़ेगा, तो कैसे वो फैमिली वहां से डिस्प्लेस हो जाएंगे और इतना बड़ा नुकसान होगा. $2 trillion की कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इन्हीं भारतीयों की वजह से अमेरिकन इकोनॉमी गए, तो उन्होंने मामला ट्रंप एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन से उठाया था. उसके बाद हम सरकार से जानना चाहते हैं कि क्या हुआ, क्या रिस्पांस हुआ, क्योंकि वहां की होमलैंड सिक्योरिटी अभी लगातार इस इश्यू पे बल दे रही है और आगे बढ़ रही है. अगर ये निर्णय हो गया तो फिर इस हजारों भारतीय बहुत मुश्किल में फंस जाएंगे. तो आपसे अनुरोध है सर, आपके माध्यम से सरकार से, कि ट्रंप प्रशासन से क्या बात हो रही है सरकार की, उस मामले में हाउस को अवगत कराएं.
के सोम प्रसाद एसोसिएट प्रफुल्ल पटेल. के सोम प्रसाद, नरेश जी
आल्सो. And an important situation emerged as a result of merger of State Bank of Travancore with the State Bank of India. A section of parents and students in Kerala who availed education loan are in panic. Repayment of education loan is a very big problem throughout India. Thousands and thousands of students who availed the loan are not in a position to repay the loan due to the unavailability of job after their studies. Considering this situation, the government of Kerala has declared an education loan relief package for the defaulted students. 900 crore rupees has been earmarked for this purpose. 60% of the loan amount will be met by the state government. The decision of the government of Kerala to execute this relief package is widely appreciated from every corner of the society. But now, almost 20,000 students who availed education loan from the State Bank of Travancore before merger with the State Bank of India are not in a position to even to apply for the relief declared by the government of Kerala. When they approached the same branch, now run by the State Bank of India, is not ready to receive application for the relief package. The SBI says that before merger, the pending liability of the State Bank of Travancore has been transferred to Reliance Assets and the Reconstruction Company. So now the loans issued by the SPT are not the liability of the State Bank of India. The SPT is no more. Attitude of the SBI is not cooperative to settle this vital issue. The relief package is that direct transfer of financial assets to the concerned bank. Neither the State Bank of India nor the Reliance Assets Reconstruction Company is ready to furnish adequate details of the loans to the government. Hence, my appeal is that the union government should interfere in this matter with its due gravity.
The question hour is over.
No, sir.
I'm very sorry. Jura hour is over. Question hour is going to start now. Please, Som Prasadji. Okay, that's why I was signaling to you. I wanted to reach the last one to Anand Sarmaji's this thing also, but I could not. But still, we have done a good work. Question one.